Hello, my beautiful Aries friends, and welcome to January of 2020. This is your horoscope. I am going to walk you through this month. We're going to talk about some significant events that are coming up. I'll give you dates and a little feedback on what you can expect from the energies that we are looking out for. Now, January, the beginning of 2020, you know, we've got the big news of the Saturn-Pluto conjunction that's going to be happening and rocking this area right up here in your 10th house, which will also give energy and life to your 4th house. As well, we've got a lunar eclipse happening at 20 degrees of Cancer on the 10th, which will give life to your home or your 4th house, which will also give life to your 10th house. So we've kind of still got this Capricorn Cancer axis going. So one of the things I want to bring your attention to before we actually jump into this forecast is to think about the year as the dance that it's going to be. As we're crossing this line coming into 2020, we are continuing to work on what was Cancer Capricorn axes. You've seen these things. You've been in them. You've known changes were coming to them. Now you're going to come at those same old things with new perspectives, new actions, new energies to move these things forward, right? It's benefit to already what was. Now, as we move further down into the year, we're starting to see some newness come to the table. But here in January, we're going to make corrections to what already is. So keep that in mind as we continue to travel and you think through how you can apply these energies to your life, right? Okay. All right, so let's start at the beginning of this month. And before we jump in, let's just pray for the board this month. This is the last recording I'm going to do in this particular house. Then we'll be moving to the new office where all the rest of the board will start to look a little bit different. So pray for the board this month, but let's jump in and look at it also. Okay, right here at the beginning of the month, we've got this interesting business going with Jupiter and Mercury. Now, this is on the second of the month. Jupiter and Mercury are actually in conjunction with each other here in your 10th house. So these are our planets of the smaller mind and the bigger mind. So what I can tell you seems very apparent, and the sun is up here as well. It's just a loaded 10th house. The 10th house, career, work, who you are in public, and this includes as well, Aries, you know, what decisions did you make at the end of 2019 that changed who you are in the world? Did you get married? So you've gone from single to now being known as a married person, or vice versa? Did you buy a car? Did you buy a house? And now you've gone from being not that to a homeowner, to a car owner. Who and what you're known as in the world is also quite impacted up here, not just career, but there is a heavy focus on career. So think about that as well as you calculate this 10th house into your energy. But with Mercury and Jupiter in conjunction here, our two planets of the mind are on the same page. They're blending together. You're thinking bigger. Maybe bigger things are happening. Bigger projects are coming together. There's more communication, or it's at a higher level. Something like that. This is a wonderful space of communication, getting some ideas that you started to form in December of 2019 together for forward motion here in 2020. Now, on the third, we're going to see Mars taking his beautiful self out of the energy of Sagittarius, and Mars is going to move, or out of the energy, excuse me, of Scorpio, and Mars is going to move his energy into Sagittarius. This is going to light up your ninth house space, Aries, okay? So Mars is action. He's energy. He's your ruling planet. So you're like, yes, team, let's go. The ninth house is publishing, broadcasting, expansion, teaching. It's a very visible place for you because you are expanding wherever this energy is at. Mars doesn't do things lightly, so he's bringing heavy energy to your table to get out there, to explore, you know, publish those YouTube videos. Is your book done? Are you ready to take on higher education? And the ninth house is also such a big house of ideas and ideals, right? Do you need to experiment with how you've been doing some things? The things that you're doing are heavily guided by the ideals that you have in your head, and some of them have been changed. They've been reformed. You're expanded. You've got more philosophy, different philosophy, bigger thinking in your back pocket, and you're going to take those with Mars action and energy out and meet the world and the people in it differently. I absolutely love it. This is also a phenomenal energy to interact with people of different cultures, positions, things like that, to start to gain a conversation, right? And it's a very social energy as well. So I look forward to see how you expand out with that particular energy. On the 10th, we're going to have this full moon lunar eclipse at 20 degrees of Cancer. So make sure you find that on your chart. And if you don't have a chart, make sure you snag one up in the description box down below or pull one for free, okay? Now, this particular eclipse happening in the fourth house is home, family, real estate, property, your emotional foundations and security, right? The things that make you feel so secure. So for the next 6 months, this lunar eclipse is going to take this balance between work and who you are in public and who you are and your responsibilities at home, and they're going to be in a little bit of a tug of war, right? You're trying to find this balance between home and family, between head and heart, between heart and just that brain space of how do I do this, between being married and being independent. You know, how do these balances work together for you? Where are your friends and your social obligations versus staying at home and having some quiet time? All of these things will be disrupted to bring to your attention the need for change in this area. Now, the lunar eclipse is going to create change for us for the next 6 months. It's going to show you where something needs to be ended, where it needs to be adjusted, where you've got to make some adjustments to it in some way, shape, or form. Because it's just going to highlight the balance of what needs to be adjusted here. Now, I do think too, again, Aries, depending on what you have taken on in 2019, let's say that you bought a home, right? This lunar eclipse says, okay, in your home life for the next 6 months, we're going to ride this train and you're going to learn to be a homeowner, right? We're going to make change in your home zone. Now, because it's a lunar energy as well, I do want to say it can bring a little bit of anxiety to the table, especially if you're taking on something new or you're ending something and stepping into something new, because it's kind of that space of the unknown. But you're here to learn. And remember, across the street at the top of this chart, Jupiter is in Capricorn. He gives you the wisdom of endurance. He's here to help you learn on this axis as well, okay? On the 11th of January, we have got Uranus, who is here, and he's been retrograde, and now he's not going to be retrograde on the 11th. So Uranus is coming out of retrograde in your second house in the energy of Taurus. Now, he's been retrograde since August of 2019. So man, you put Uranian energy and Taurus energy together and they are both so stubborn, right? They do have that in common, even if Uranus isn't completely thrilled with being in Taurus and Taurus is not completely thrilled with having Uranian energy there. They are both so stubborn. So now, here in your money house, in your money zone, the question I would ask you with Uranus retrograde is, over the last months, what has Uranus shown you in terms of where you've got to stop being so stubborn with your money, where you've got to not dig in your heels so much and maybe make some fresh changes here? Certainly, you bought a house, you got married, someone's moving into your house. This will change where your money is going to go. It will change your understanding of your money, for sure, your finances, your value, all of those things. But with Uranus retrograde, he's ready to help you shake it up a little, get out of the rut, see things with a fresh perspective, bigger perspective, right? Because Uranus is also a planet that is highly intuitive, but it also favors long-range goals and your ambitions. So this is a setup for long-term success in your money. Now, depending on where you are in the world, the 11th to 12th, we're going to see this Saturn-Pluto conjunction at 22 degrees up here in your 10th house. Now, Saturn and Pluto together, they create this slow evolutionary change and burn. And if you haven't watched my yearly video, please check it out. But as these two come together, what it can feel like is loss, because they're going to say, all right, Aries, here's what needs to die off, Pluto, and here's the next level we're going to go to, the next set of responsibilities we're going to take on, Saturn energy. So as these guys come together, you see what you need to let go of in order to make satisfactory, successful progress in your work. This doesn't mean that your career is gonna fall out and hit the floor and go splat, but it's gonna tell you and show you, hey, what's not working in this career? Where do we need to make this horizon bigger? Where can we step up? Remember, maybe you've become a homeowner, a spouse, a whatever your new name in the world is, and you're learning to step into that behavior. But it means you've got to put down your old behaviors in this particular area so that you can advance and expand into this new area. This is not doomsday at all. It is simply an opportunity for you to evolve, and the evolution we have this energy happen, it feels like a loss has happened, and you start growing immediately for the universe to fill the hole, because the universe never leaves a hole. So this energy is abundant, but I don't want to be delusional with you. If it feels painful, if it feels like loss, if it feels like I'm not sure what to do, your answers are coming in the next couple days as we move into the 11th house energies, because it'll give you new teachers to show you how to walk this next leg of your journey, okay? All right, so as we get to January 13th, what's going to happen first is that Venus is going to move into the energy of Pisces. Okay, Venus lighting up the 12th house. This is always interesting because it can bring someone back from your past, an old love. But the thing that I keep thinking about is at the end of the month on the 27th, Venus is going to be exact in this conjunction with Neptune. And that's kind of a foggy energy. But what it makes me think of is maybe here Venus in the 12th house is maybe you were hurt, or you hurt someone, or you felt afraid in this particular area. You've had fears. And now with this business happening at the top of the chart, with an eclipse happening at the bottom of the chart, you're coming to grips and coming to some honesty and admitting to yourself something you've been very uncomfortable with. And now you're ready to work them through. Now you're getting in position to transition those out and allow new information in. Yes, it can bring old lovers back. It can bring a time where maybe you're wanting to be quiet with your loved ones, or you're feeling like you just need to take a deep breath and kind of have some downtime. Let your intuition guide you. But what I would tell you is if something or someone, even an opportunity, does come back from the past, give it a little bit of time so that you make sure you've got all of the information ready and available to you very, very clearly, okay? On the 16th, the action happens that will help you with this business up here. On the 16th, we've got Mercury now ready to leave, and he's here in the energy of Aquarius, right? We get to the 20th, and we've got the Sun jumping ship, and she's ready to be in the energy of Aquarius. Let's do it this way. Okay, and then we get to the 24th of the month, where we've got this new moon business happening in the energy of Aquarius. So from the 16th of the month down, your 11th house gets lit up. The 11th house is the house of Uranus, right? Long range plans and goals, your ambitions, your future, moving you forward. What are the actions we're gonna take to move Aries forward? This is friends, social groupings, anything you're connected to in terms of organizations or people taking on your energies, your social networks online. Where do you need a bump up? Where do you need to reevaluate this area, reset this area? It's a new moon. What do you want to start fresh here? Maybe you just bought a house or got married, or you're changing something in your security. Do you want to have some people over? Are you wanting to commit to having some social stuff happen in your year? The other thing that is here is information, right? I just told you, you have changed in this 10th house area. You have changed. You need new information and people to help you walk how to make your vision of your future come true moving forward. And this is your information space. That new moon is your opportunity to attract in exactly what you're looking for in terms of the information you need to tighten up that social group, to do anything you need to do to help you be seen and move forward. All right, as we're closing out this month, I do want to just bring up two dates for you, Aries, to keep in mind. First, the first one I told you about is the 27th, when Venus and Neptune are actually conjunct here in this 12th house. Information is just not super clear. Now, Venus and Neptune, I love these two together. They're the Bopsy twins. They're very blissful. Things are so good, so delicious, so indulgent. Again, some romance, maybe an investment could be on the table. This is a foggy day. This is a foggy set of energy, so I would just give it time to make sure you've got all your facts and all of your energy so they don't come back to bite you. Now, the same is true on the 28th, where we'll have Mars, who's here in Sagittarian energy, coming into a square with this Neptune-Venus situation over here. And this is, again, the energy where I'm telling you, if you were hurt, if you made a mistake in the past, if you, whatever it is from your past or from what you're trying to transition out, this square is activating you to take action, to take accountability, to take responsibility, to clear that closet out so that you can move forward in the truth, free from rumors, free from guilt, free from doubt, and just continue to march on. But those are foggy days, and I want to just give you a heads up on that, because they might not be the best days to make super big decisions, but they are good days for reflection and figuring out what's going on in that 12th house, okay? All right, Aries, I think January starts out with the pop it's supposed to. Let's get in there. Let's walk this thing. Keep me posted on what's happening in your journey in the comment section down below. I'm always rooting for you. These planets are rooting for you. It's a cosmic conspiracy to help you on the journey that you're here to take. So like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I hope you are signed up for the forecast marathon coming in just a couple days, January 9th through the 12th with Astrology Hub. If you still haven't signed up, you want to get signed up. It's free. Do it in the description box down below, okay? I love you guys, and I will see you in February. Bye, everyone.